Today on the Dr. Steve Show, watch me go under the knife. Well, the laser, LASIK surgery like you've never seen it before. You'll meet my surgeon, too, talk about how I'm doing.
This is Dr. Steve.
You may not know this, but I'm actually someone who never used to wear glasses until about 10 years ago. That's when my vision took a bit of a dive. Reading became a problem, and so did seeing stuff that was far away. Now, I hadn't thought about LASIK surgery until I met Dr. Richard Norton on an earlier show. Well, we decided to bring Dr. Norton back. Welcome, Dr. Norton. Good to see you again.
Thanks, pleasure.
And, you know, I'm happy to say my surgery was a success. You've done how many thousands of these?
A couple.
No, honestly.
Probably about 10, 15,000. Yeah.
10 or 15,000. So I was pretty comfortable. And I have to say that the surgery really surprised me. It was not as big a deal. Like, a lot of people are afraid of it. Do you find that people, after they go through it, they have less, like, they're like, wow, it wasn't as bad as I thought?
100%. You know, there's the common anxiety of your eyesight, and everybody leans forward and says to me, Doc, these are my eyes. They're very important to me. Mm. And, you know, for everybody, that's the case. So, you know, there's that apprehension. What if something goes wrong with my vision? Well, LASIK surgery is actually safer than wearing contact lenses. People don't know that. So everybody uniformly, when it's over, say, wow, that wasn't so bad at all. It's pretty easy.
Okay. So what I want to do is I want to take people through, like, the procedure and what we went through. So first, I want to talk about the preparation that we went through in your office in Ridgewood, New Jersey. And we have some video of that. And kind of like just explain to people what they can expect as they're preparing. Because I have to be honest with you, it was a lot more preparation than I realized.
Yeah, we try to go through a very comprehensive eye exam. We'll go through a thorough history, medical history, and then we'll check your vision. We'll check your vision with glasses. We check your vision without glasses. We'll measure your prescription. If you're, you know, like some people over 40 or 45 and we want to do the monovision, we'll check your near vision. We'll check your eye dominance because it's important to make sure that the dominant eye is set for distance.
Right, and that's what I had done, because that was what I went for, was the monovision, not standard. So basically, one eye is for close-up. And one eye is for distance. But you also take a very thorough look at the cornea, right? There's this intense mapping that goes on.
Yeah, we have several mapping machines. And in addition to visually scanning the cornea with a slit lamp, we look at these sophisticated maps that are produced to look for a special condition called keratoconus, which is probably one of the few contraindications to LASIK.
Okay, now I want to get to it, because here's a surgery right there on the monitor. This is when I went under, and I mean under the machine. I was not under, you should know, I was awake the whole time during the procedure, which was incredible because it was really painless. And so walk us through here, because I think when people see this, they think, oh, I could never have that in my eye, but I did not feel anything. What is that going on there?
So here we're making some marks on the cornea before we actually create the little protective flap in the cornea. So when we lift that little protective flap, we know exactly that we're putting it back in the correct orientation. Mm-hmm. And those little lines there help us do it.
Right.
Now here we are placing a special ring that holds the eye in place. And this is the machine, microkeratome, and there is some controversy today as how the best, what's the best method of creating a flap. Well, this is, we just created a flap there, and you saw in about 3-4 seconds.
Yeah.
It's an amazingly quick and sophisticated process. And after we do that, we then lift that little protective flap, which we'll do momentarily. We're just drying up the cornea a little bit here and drying up the eye.
I have to say I'm impressed with your steady hands. Watch this as you pick up this flap. I'm like, okay. And by the way, I should mention that when this is happening, you don't really see that. It's so close, it's like you don't appreciate it. It's like you're just, the whole time, you're just like, you're guiding me through, and everything that you said was exactly what I saw. You're like, you may see a little gray, you may feel this, and it was exactly like you said.
Well, you know, because we've done this a few times, we know pretty much what to tell people, what to expect. And that the biggest apprehension, people feel like they don't know what's going to happen to them. So if we tell them in advance, you're going to be feeling this, feeling that, nobody wants to know what's being done. They want to know what they're going to be feeling right before it happens.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting to see that, you know, as it's happening. The squeegee thing was pretty cool. That's what you're doing. This is after we were done. I remember that thing going by my eye and thinking, I didn't even feel that.
Yeah. Yeah,
that was really cool.
And this is just to you make sure the flap is aligned and that we've squeegeed the water out between the flap and the undersurface.
Okay. Now, what was really interesting, so we did the one eye, then we did the other eye, and literally right after that, I got up, which you see me kind of like getting up right there. And, you know, before when I had my glasses off, everything was blurry. I couldn't see anything. And I did look down at my watch, and I actually could see my watch pretty clearly. I mean, the distance was all, it was all watery, you know, because it was just after the procedure, but very impressive. Right there, I'm looking down. I remember thinking, well, I could really see my watch.
Yeah, and you probably couldn't have seen it, but 5 years ago or 10 years ago.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't. Now, this is the next day follow-up, so people should understand, you know, it's serious. Oh, well, no, that's we're celebrating. That's
right after
the surgery. Okay, but we did have follow-up. That's the next day follow-up. You do come back the next day for follow-up and talk about some of that recovery that goes on, what you're looking for, things like that.
Well, generally, the vast majority of people see between a 90 and 95% improvement the next morning. So virtually everybody can drive themselves in for their appointment the next day. They're usually able to read and get on a computer and that sort of thing without any difficulty. Most people actually do go back to work the next day. We do try to check the vision. We look and see what you're able to read the next day and compare it to what you could before, and also your distance vision as well. And then we also want to make sure that by the next day, 99% of the time, if there were to be an infection or inflammation or any problem, we would detect it the next day. So
yeah, well, it's all great. I mean, there can be some adjustment after a while. Let's go through that just so people understand. Not everybody pops off and is great in 24, 48 hours, right?
Absolutely. So I would say a significant majority of people, I would say virtually everyone sees well enough to drive the next mm-hmm. day. But in terms of their final vision, you know, probably 50% are very close to it. The other half can take a few days, even a week or two, even sometimes a little longer. But most people are functional. If they're not 100% functional right away, we can always help them out with a weak pair of glasses or a contact lens for a week or 2 weeks until they're really functional and ready to go.
Well, Dr. Norton, it's been about a week for me, and I can tell you I'm functional. I mean, I can look here, I can read the teleprompter. It's all working out great. It's so good to see
you.
Thanks. I really appreciate
it. Real pleasure, Steve. Thank you.